English Tim here. Today I'm doing a video about the Stone Sentinel. Now, it also works for the Golem, so anything I say here can work as well. However, I think for the Stone Sentinel, for the Camelot Challenge event, it's worth going that extra mile. So I'm going to go through some of those things you probably wouldn't normally do for the Golem, but are worth doing for this extra powerful event. Debtor, yeah, not that one. There we go, Debtor, CHF. Now, Debtor, we were having a chat yesterday about how he's managed to get up. We're very, very similarly matched. We're both low spenders, and yeah, he's managed to jump me by six places by playing with his playing with all his settings yesterday. So today it's my turn. I'm coming to get you, Debtor. Time for us to even the score. So most of the things I'm saying on this require gold. So if you're running short on gold, don't forget that using Amazon coins, you can get a 20% discount when you buy packs on King of Avalon. So let's check it out now. Okay, so let's check out the event now. So if we go to the Camelot Championship, you'll see that currently our lead damage is done by Kay. He's the second in the entire event. So if we check out the leaderboard, there we go, second. He's got ahead of Coaxedang and Immortal currently, and Tricky. So doing extremely well. So we need to support him, give him the best team he can possibly get. And at the minute, where am I? I'm 46, so the top 50 will get into the event, so I am technically still in there, but boy is it close. Now if we scroll down, I've got a few of my alliance mates, and where is it? So yeah, well, I need to make sure I at least stay in the top 50, but it would be lovely if I can make it into that get into the top 40 and clear Debtor's account. So how are we going to do it? How are we going to catch Debtor? How are we going to make that point count? So I'm at, what is it currently? 28 million odd damage, and Debtor is at 31 million. So I've got to do 10% more damage to be able to catch up there. So I've already done some tweaking yesterday. Let's do some more tweaking today. So first up, you want to use all of my Golem tips that I put in my Golem video already. So check that video out up here, and that will tell you everything you need to know about the basics for the Golem. And now let's go and extend on that. So we're going to do everything that's standard. So we've got all of our best gear on. We've also got our talent points set for fighting, and we've changed to your draconic skills for fighting. Now the hero council, this is one where you need to be careful. Your best heroes are not necessarily going to be the ones you want. You've got to remember in this event, the most important troops that are fighting are your bow first up, they do the most damage, and cavalry. Now you don't want to send just bow, you don't want to send just cavalry. You want to send your best critical march, and you want to do everything you can to improve A, their attack, B, damage. So bowman attack, bowman damage, cavalry attack, cavalry damage. These are the four things that you need to focus on most. So why am I looking at my hero council? Well, my normal best hero council, let's go and point the heroes here. So normally I've got Orlando the Night Shard. He's got better stats overall, but I've only unlocked three of his skills, which means if you check out the skills, it's cavalry defense, bowman defense, cavalry health. None of those help about against the Golem or the Stone Sentinel. However, Madoc, he does have bowman attack and cavalry attack, so those two are very, very helpful. So actually my less powerful hero, Madoc, is the one to use today in the council. Same when you're doing your marches. You need to make sure you're using marches that focus on cavalry, what, bowman first if possible, cavalry second. So when you send your march, those heroes you're going to send are going to be potentially not your top two heroes currently. So currently your best heroes to be sending are actually going to be Kiara and generally King Lot, assuming you've got them and they're moderately well advanced, then almost certain to be your best choice ahead of the two newest heroes, Orlando and Ursa. So before you use a calculator, you want to set up your maximum march. So know your rough number, how many troops you're going to send. Is it 500,000, 600,000? Work out that number so you can chuck it into your march calculator. So how do you find out the best march you should send? Because that is a really, really core part of this. So I'm using Siri's March Calculator. Now, if you check out my earlier video here, I tell you about the calculator, and I've run the stats. So you chuck in your battle stats on the stats page. You then need to go to your troops page and make sure you tick the tier of troops that you have, and then it'll give you a march based on that. Now the one downside is I've said I'm going to build a few T11, but it wants me to build 140,000. I doubt I'm going to do that. So I'm going to have to switch out these T11s for more T13s, T12s to balance that out. Now this has given me a great starting point for my march, and you want to be trying to match it. So you can see actually a lot of bowmen, not a lot of T13 cavalry, a lot more bowmen of all sorts, and a small amount of infantry just to mix it up, because I don't have that many tiers of bow currently. So you've got your perfect march, you've set that up in your march slot. What else can you do? Now, there are still a lot of things. So you can increase your march capacity. More troops is better. So how are you going to bump your march capacity? Well, first up, Lord Talents, make sure you've got them set. Now you've got the city buffs. This one you should use a lot. So let's go in there and set this up now. Don't need to worry about defense on this. The Golem doesn't fight back. The Stone Sentinel doesn't fight back. You don't have to worry about your defense stats. It's all about attack. It's all about damage. So you want to hit up your most powerful attack boost and your march capacity boost. Now, I could use the 50% one, but they're really expensive. I'm saving them for a rainy day. I hope I don't need to use it. So I'm going to start out with my 25% boost, and that has maxed out everything that you can do in here. So we've maxed out that march capacity. What else can you do to increase your march cap? So if we go into your lord, and then if you go into your temporary relics, we've got the crown of command here. So I'm going to put that on. That will boost my troops further. So here I can add an extra 15%. Now that 15% is going to make a big deal. You can also do the Dragon Blade. There are different versions of it. So the Battle Blade is the cheaper version, and you can switch from your crown. Once you've sent the march, switch to your Battle Blade. It's actually only a very small benefit, 15% on your troop attack. Now, if I'm desperate, I might hit that one up again, but that's 2,000 gold. I think you can spend your gold better. However, if you've got loads of gold, chuck it on and remember to do the switch before your attack arrives. Now you want to do really important one, Hall of War. If you're anything like me, you had them set up for an infantry defense base, and nothing about defense is helpful here. So you can reset your tomes. It'll cost you 1,000 gold. This one will pay for itself. This is really, really important. So you want to focus on getting that bowman attack up. No iron skin. This is not helpful. Arrows of Vengeance. This one will help. It'll add to all of your different troop tiers. So if you've got lots of troops, tiers of bow, that's a good one. Now also the specific attack boost for the level you're fighting with. So out of interest, the level 13 and up, the cost gets higher. It's two of your tomes at each level. So actually much more difficult to do that level. Level 12, that's much easier. Level 11, easier too. Now I might reset it and add some level 11 once I've started to build some T11 bowmen. For now, I've got it set up without that, as I didn't have them when I last ran this. So yeah, now if we check out your dragon, there's a few things you can do here. So if you go into dragon, and then if you go into the skill section. Now nurture, you probably got that evolved as far as you can. There's no really tweaking, but in skills there are tweaks you can make. So for example, you could reset these skills here, and so for example, wounded conversion, troop health, none of those are going to help you today. So you can reset those, and if you haven't got full level 31 skills, you can try and bump up, for example, bowman damage and also cavalry damage. These are all going to help you a lot. So yeah, reset those skills if you need to. I've got them all maxed out at the minute, so nothing for me to do there. However, evolution. Now this one, I have evolved my wounded conversion, and that's great for normal battling, but this is not great for KVK, but it's not going to help me today. So if I go to evolve, and you can reset this, and you see you can get back all of your different things that you've invested in it, but you do need to get some of these scrolls. It'll cost you 100 gold, probably still worth it. So I've reset that one, and now I'm able to evolve some other skills. So which one we've got, the cavalry damage is already up, the bowman damage is already up, but we can now do bowman attack, and this will increase the bowman versus infantry. Golem is treated like infantry, and you get the bowman attack boost. So if I evolve this one, you'll see I'm going to start getting a major boost. So now I've got bowman attack 155 and bowman versus infantry 96.1. Now have I got any others I can do? So yeah, I could actually take out the March of Fury. Oh no, actually I need the March of Fury, I need the March capacity. Okay, so I've got the maximum I can do with the stones that I've got available, so I've done another little boost there. Now the thing is, do you want to start doing some upgrades? It's possible that this might be worth doing. Think about the shop event though, it'll be coming up in a few weeks' time. Do you really want to give up those shop event points to boost your position? If you really need that top 50, might be worth rejigging your gear. So for example, dismantling your gear and upgrading those which have the most bowman attack, most cavalry attack. I'm not going to do that now. Have a play with yourselves, and keep in mind that you might accidentally raise your high score, and that might make you perform a lot less well in the shop event. Your choice on that one. Also check, make sure your accolades are running. Sometimes you can let them run out, so appearance and accolades. So these ones here, you want to make sure your Labyrinth Explorers are all still running. They've got major boosts. So if you've also, you can do some skins on your castle, which might well improve your stats as well. So keep that in mind if you've got the skins lying around. Okay, so we've got the Colossal March here. Really important. Use it at the last minute. It's going to take 30 minutes. You only get it for 30 minutes. And then we've also got the Breath of Fire that also lasts 30 minutes. So you want those both to kick in at the same time when you're ready to go. Now, question, do you want to teleport close by so that you can do more attacks? There are an unlimited number of attacks, so keep going. Out of interest, if you're using critical marches, you'll get big boosts sometimes, smaller ones other times, so don't just hit it once and say, that's my best. Hit it with exactly the same march multiple times. You'll do more damage sometimes than others, and the more times you try, the more the chances are you're going to hit that critical hit way more frequently. Okay, so here is the Stone Centurion. I'm going to head over. Now, if you want to leave it far enough away that you can switch before you get there, it might be worth going one extra space further away. And then we can teleport in, and we can start making those hits. So I'm going to hit that Colossal March, set up my march with the right troops, and let's see what we can do now. So if we check out the Siri calculator, I'm just going to move this over to my other screen so I can do it more quickly. So it's not a lot, but let's start with what we've got. Might be enough. Let's throw all my death throwers in there. Okay, rank 46 currently, 28 million damage. Let's hit that 6 march. Let's see how we do this time. Boom, there it is. First hit. Now let's check the numbers. Okay, so I dealt 31 million. So I got myself up to 40 in my first effort. So where are we now? Oh, there it is. One place ahead of Detta. That was really, really, really tight. 2,000 damage. So, I am EnglishTim. Thanks for watching today. If you enjoy my content, hit that subscribe button and click on the notification bell and you'll get updated about my future videos. So, here's that video I was telling you about. This is the original increasing your PvE damage against the Golem. See everything you can do in this version of the video too. Thanks for watching today.